we are very proud to host the KE-CIRT at the Communications Authority of Kenya.
Okay.
This is an entity that works 24/7 to look out, detect these attacks, prevent them, and advise the entities that are targeted.
Oh, so you flag us?
Yes.
Oh, great.
And once we flag that out on our radar, as it were, we then reach out immediately.
Hey, welcome back to my channel. Please subscribe and look out for this item. Today we're having a conversation that everybody knows is very, very close to my heart, and it's a conversation on cybersecurity. And the person joining me to have that conversation, it's a long way since Hall 12. And that's all we're going to say about that.
Yeah.
Let people ask you when they meet you.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
She's the acting DG for the Communications Authority. You're my regulator.
Yes, indeed.
Don't be like that. Mercy Wanjau. So, I want us to get into the heavy conversation, but we will finish here because this is very close to my heart.
Okay.
My children are 8 and 20 months going on 18. Seriously. So, I understand. So, October is officially Cybersecurity Month.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. But finally, we have a body to handle cybersecurity, which sits under the Communications Authority of Kenya. Is that true?
That's right.
Introduce me to that body.
Okay. Thanks very much, Carol, for having me on the set today. Perhaps I should give you a context against which to introduce this body by way of sharing the Kenya's ICT indicators as we stand today.
Okay.
Because it's important to know where you are, because that informs some of the things that you do that others might not necessarily do. Kenya's ICT indicators are very, very high.
Yes.
Very progressive and very likable towards Western statistics. Our mobile subscriptions stand at 109.2%, meaning we are over-gadgeted, over-devised.
I love that term, we're over-devised.
We are over-devised.
Okay.
As a country.
Uh-huh.
Our mobile money transfer services in terms of value of transactions as we speak stands at 2.1 trillion Kenya shillings.
That figure I knew. Yeah. And I kept saying, I want me some of that.
Well, we can see how you can get some of that.
Yes.
It's very high.
Uh-huh.
Our free-to-air TV channels are at 86.
Mine being one of them.
And yours being one of them. And the number of FM stations is at 173.
That I knew.
Yeah.
Yes.
Our broadband connectivity is at about 44.5% against an African average of about 10-15%.
No.
So have that context in mind. Because what it means is that you and I, our children and our families have access to content and speeds that are unprecedented.
Wow.
On this continent.
Okay. You know, I knew about our speeds. I didn't know that's how it breaks down.
That's how it breaks down. So we are really in a very high-tech space living in Kenya. And that does have a lot of benefits in terms of accessing content, a lot of functionality, a lot of innovation. And this is why Kenya has earned a reputation internationally, you know, in thought leadership in the ICT innovation space.
Okay.
That's the good stuff.
Uh-huh.
But then there's also the unexpected stuff, the unintended consequences.
Which is?
Which is issues, for example, like cyberbullying, cyber threats.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of compromising of systems and networks in our businesses. If I'm to look at small and medium enterprises, which are very much to my heart, I like small and medium enterprises. Those are the backbone for driving Kenya's economy forward. A lot of these businesses are backed by women.
Yes.
If these women, during their thinking time, are not having a conversation about the cybersecurity in their business, their devices and their networks, then they're missing out on a very, very strategic conversation.
Can I freak you out?
Yeah.
Last week, my partner, Nelly, from Pauline Cosmetics, was sitting over there, and she looked stressed and asked her, what's wrong? She said, the site has, somebody was attempting to hack the site.
Yeah.
I said, we sell cosmetics. She said, yeah, but I had to take down the whole site to put a patch on it.
Right.
I'm like, who needs her site?
Well, you know, your
site. SMEs, are you listening?
Yeah, your site.
Is your business.
Is your business.
Yes.
It contains a lot of data. Your own personal data, your customers, your suppliers, your products, your images. If your competitor could have that information, it gives them a fast track. in terms of acquisition of data that is of value.
In my world, I thought the only person susceptible to cyber attack is big business.
No.
But I remember she was on and talking, not so I was like, what's wrong? She said somebody tried to hack the Pauline Cosmetics site. I was like,
yeah,
but we have face powder and eyeshadow.
Yeah, but your data is of high value.
Wow.
To somebody else. It will help consolidate their database and push their products or other information, because the data protection bill is at an advanced stage, mm-hmm. As we speak, which comes in to complement the efforts on cybersecurity, because they go hand in hand.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the principles that we must all learn, even as individuals, and observe, is that when you get data belonging to an individual, because, for example, you're selling Pauline Cosmetics,
true,
and then you turn into a land seller,
mm-hmm.
you cannot use the data you got for one purpose,
yes.
and reuse it
for another
purpose.
Because you're like, I'll just migrate all my contacts, as we call it.
Yes.
Yes.
And use them for a second purpose. That is wrong. Unless.
Munasikia.
Unless the person who gave you the original data.
Has said yes. Yes.
Only then. So you see, things are getting deeper and more complex, because a lot of these things happen where you find, for example, an educational institution, a medical institution, they're approached because they have huge pools that would be useful for insurance, for example, or
yes.
financial services
yes.
or some other service. And maybe they might even give this data in exchange for value.
But my friend, of course.
But unless they have given consent. They have consent from the owners of that information. They cannot do that. So that's a conversation in the data protection space. It's a conversation on the cybersecurity space. And it then takes me down the lane to, what about those of our populations who are vulnerable, like children?
Okay.
And they're engaging with these gadgets. They are participating in this same ecosystem that we are in.
Mm-hmm.
And because they are young, they are vulnerable, they're impressionable. If the child has not been trained on net etiquette,
yes,
they will go out there, their name, their age, their school, where we live, what we do,
mm-hmm.
when we are at home, when my parents are not at home, what I do. If you want to get in touch with me, you can find me here. They can share such sensitive information.
And remember, we're always grooming them from the time they can talk.
Right.
This is your mother's name.
Right.
This is where you live.
Right.
So obviously they'll
put shared
it out
on
there.
The wrong platform.
Oh my goodness.
Utter disaster. So it's very important that we have this conversation. Because as you see from the conversation so far, it starts right from me and you to our families, our children, small and medium enterprises, big enterprises, government, private sector.
Paint me
it cuts
a picture.
Across.
Now that you've made me realize SMEs need to be listening to what you're saying, we need to be conversant, but paint me a picture because numbers are important. Okay, I mean, okay, fine, we're good, but
mm-hmm.
who's after us? How many attacks can we possibly have? 1,000, 2,000 a year?
Oh, you'll be shocked. You'll be shocked. When the KE-CIRT, the Computer Incident Response Team, which is the body that sits within Communications Authority of Kenya, was established,
mm-hmm.
It sits to detect
mm-hmm.
and to prevent
mm-hmm.
and to protect citizens, systems, and businesses from cyber threats. And this was pushed by the realization that this online space
mm-hmm.
it's coming, and it's coming at a very fast rate. Last year, the statistics of cyber threats detected stood at about 11.3 million cyber threats.
Mm-hmm.
As at the end of the quarter that ended June,
mm-hmm.
the risk stood at 56 million.
What?
That's half a year. So what are we saying as we move on?
Oh, I thought there were a few thousands. I didn't realize
we are talking in the millions. And this is because Kenya, as part of its Vision 2030 strategy,
mm-hmm.
the digital footprint, is trying to deepen the digital economy.
Of course.
It's trying to really use the ICT platform as a tool for delivery.
Mm-hmm.
Government to government, government to citizen, citizen to business.
This individual to individual.
Individual to individual.
Uh-huh.
This is a platform that we are looking at because it's a game changer. So with the increasing adoption of this platform, like now we pay our taxes online.
Yes.
We pay a lot of bills online.
Oh my goodness,
a lot
my
of
heart
purchases.
Rate just went up. I had not thought about that.
Yes.
Like if you hit KRA, once again, the numbers, threats to our systems, to us as a nation,
mm-hmm.
that have been detected.
Right.
Are, to this part of the year, we're already at about 25 million?
Right.
detected.
Right.
So what goes undetected is something else.
You know, we do not know.
Where we will end up.
Uh-huh. You know, but those statistics, you can see an upward trajectory and it's getting steeper. As you compare last year's statistics and these ones are coming on and fast and furious.
And fast and furious.
Right. And
because we are on the map.
We are on the map, big time.
Individually and
corporately.
And corporately.
And government-wise. And
so give me an idea of, you know, where when you see, because I'm sure, you know, data is everything, analysis of that data is everything. What sort of institutions consistently are a target for? Is it, I know financial services are always working overtime to firewall everything.
Yes.
But what else?
Actually, the trends are similar across the world. Financial services are the most sought after. Mm-hmm. And this is why they have put in a lot of resources, time and effort to firewall continuously. Mm-hmm. Health services, energy,
health?
Transport.
Why?
Because data. The data. And you know, as they say, data is the new oil.
What?
It's the new fuel.
Everything.
So access to that kind of data and with deployment of new emerging technologies, artificial intelligence, robotics, analytics, it enables you to thrash out information that would then inform a lot of other efforts in that area.
But and actually, you don't have to pay to get that data because it takes too long. So you might as well hack a system and get it.
Yeah, and this is why we are very proud to host the KE-CIRT at the Communications Authority of Kenya.
Okay.
This is an entity that works 24/7 to look out, detect these attacks, prevent them, and advise the entities that are targeted.
Oh, so you flag us?
Yes.
Oh, great.
And once we flag that out on our radar, as it were, we then reach out immediately to the institution that is faced by this attack, alert them, and ask them to take cautionary measures. And we also do reach out even further for them to come back to us
and tell us
what they have done.
Yes.
Or are you having challenges doing it? Because remember, you're only as strong as your weakest link.
That's true.
So as a nation, there's the physical security for which we have the defense forces. Mm-hmm. But there is this other layer that represents such high threat. And we can only be as strong as a nation depending on how we bolster our weakest link. So we're in all this together.
Are you understanding what she's saying? Because the truth is, yes, we can have a defense force on the ground, but the cyberspace has no boundaries.
Right.
Is literally space.
Right.
So somebody has to protect
and
that.
This is why you see these numbers, 56 million, you know, for crying out loud.
If we had been attacked by 56 million people.
Physical, it would be tragic.
Of course.
But this is happening and it's all over the world. And this is why, as a country, you cannot sit and say that you're protecting yourself, you're taking care of yourself. We need each other. So there's a lot of mutual legal cooperation that happens across countries, across continents.
That was the next thing I was going to ask you. Are we talking to other people?
Yes, very much so. And they're also talking to us. Because remember, a lot of these activities, some of them are fueled by intentional international syndicates.
Yes.
Intentional.
Yes.
So, and some of them drive very unfortunate activities, child pornography.
Yes.
Child trafficking.
Yes.
Drugs.
Mm-hmm.
So because of this, it can get very sophisticated. It can get very deep. It can get very extensive. Mm-hmm. And cyber criminals are in the business of continuously improving their cyber criminal skills.
Of course.
So it means that on the side of the threat receiving, you also have to up your game and constantly be on the lookout, build capacity, gain awareness, build collaborations, deepen your linkages and relationships, because only then can you say that you have a formidable report or response to this kind of rising cyber threats.
I hope you're paying attention. I mean, initially when we started this conversation, I understood, yes, cyber attacks, yes, but I just did not realize how vulnerable, once again, we all are, from an unseen enemy, because it comes through your phone, your computer, your system, your servers.
Right.
Yes.
And maybe I should mention something on the phone.
Yes.
I mean, we are now very over-gadgeted, as I said.
Yes.
We're at about 116% as a nation.
Yes.
On your phone.
Yes.
If it's a smartphone, I know you have very many apps.
Yes.
That help you wake up, help you sleep, help you read, help you sing. Mm-hmm. They do all manner of things.
Yes.
One of the biggest vulnerabilities around devices is the existence of third-party applications on the phone. So even as you go into these stores and download all these apps, mm-hmm. buying some, always ask yourself, let wisdom prevail. What are the security setups for this application?
What can you allow and not allow?
Allow. In opening this door for this application, am I actually opening up to this application only, or are there some other unseen guests? And exercise wisdom and seek to verify. So more and more I say, when you deal with your service provider, don't see it as a very transactional operation. Let it be a partnership. Because every day we are learning new things. You need advice, guidance, insight, especially if your gadget is also shared by other stakeholders like mine is, who are younger. Then you, all the more why you need to exercise wisdom.
I need a break here. She just referred to her children as stakeholders. I hear that term all the time, but her device is shared by other stakeholders.
Stakeholders.
Those are stakeholders.
Right.
Please subscribe, call your friends, and get serious. And actually, in no particular order, I just want to talk about the areas where these attacks happen. It's energy, it's telcos, obviously, ISPs, financial services, we all knew that, transport. And I realized, yes, we're talking about the aviation industry.
Right.
We're talking about SDR tickets.
Yes. NTSA.
Watcha.
Yes.
So what you need to do is inform yourself. I just followed the authority on Twitter. They had followed me. My regulator is doing everything in their power to make sure that you know what you need to know. But I want to come back to these stakeholders.
Yes.
Because I think the conversation has to start at a very micro level.
Right.
Because if we don't understand it from there, then when the budget comes on the table to enhance our cybersecurity
security
at the office, we knock that thing
completely
down.
Completely.
Yes.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So subscribe and come back.
Yeah.